We celebrate.
Show to your grave and we take you out now. So we are coming, we take. from two places. We all minister from two places. We minister from our portion, and we minister from our overflow. We all minister from two places. We either minister from our portion, or we minister from our overflow. Our portion is what God gives us to sustain us. It's what God gives a father to give out to his sons as an inheritance. It's called his portion. Everybody say portion. But then you also have the overflow. We see this in Psalm 23, where the scripture says, God anoints our head with oil, and our cup overflows. It is through the overflow that we minister to people. If you minister from your portion, when you finish ministering, when you go home, you feel depressed. You feel heaviness. You feel suicide. But when you minister from your overflow, whenever you give it out, God doubles the deposit. We don't minister from two places, our portion or our overflow. Our overflow is determined by our depth. Our depth is what we call the depth of a gift. Every single person in here has depth. God has excavated them or dug out in them through experiences, through encounters, through circumstances or situations. Every season that you survive digs another piece of you out today. The more God digs out of you, the more space he has to fill. The more space he has to fill, the more your cup runs over, the more your cup overflows, and the more the nations are blessed. We all minister from two places, our portion or our overflow. Our overflow, when we minister from our overflow, the scripture says that out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. Touch somebody and say overflow. Overflow. But in order for you to have depth, there has to be a dimension of digging that hits your life. You have to allow God to dig out of you. Digging. Digging is a prophetic action done with apostolic aggression. Digging is a prophetic action done with apostolic aggression. We don't just pray, we dig in prayer. That means the moment you leave your living, we've just begun. Amen. Once you get tired, that's when we start. You don't just worship, you dig in worship. You don't just give, you dig in giving. You don't just praise, you dig in praise. See, one of the things we have to do as pastors in Atlanta, we have to prepare. Because one of the things that you were experiencing worship fatigue. Because when pastors continually constrict our services, amen, and we shorten the worship time lower and lower and lower again, we begin to make the worshiper inebriated. So the moment we worship the past 20 minutes, all of our energy begins to go down. Because we only have a shallow well to draw from. But today, the Lord said, I did it. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. To dig out, to remove all the dirt, all the sin, all the
I let them because of my insecurities, but you sent me brave deeds.
Grace. there's such an amazing atmosphere that's happening right here. And something incredible happens when we breathe in and when we breathe out. All the things that we exhale are the things that shouldn't be in our bodies anyway. And all the things that we inhale is what's giving our bodies new life. So as Raine sings that again, what I want to ask you to do is just to breathe.